You know, the golf, I was sitting by the number one tee waiting for him to come back with the 18 green, was sitting right next to the number one tee off. Now I was sitting there by the tee off and watched all these people come and tee off, and if somebody was smoking, I would say, Jesus doesn't love you when you smoke. I was an evangelist. I used to go around passing out literature when they would have crusades in Bangkok, and I would go and I would put them up on telephone poles, and I would, you know, put them on doorposts and different places, and I just hand them out to total strangers. I was an evangelist. I went to crusades, I conducted crusades. We've had summer camps, I was a summer camp counselor. Mission trips. Lord. Here at church, we've had summer recovery, we've had Chip, we've had Ace. We go to visit Brookdale, visit Coles. We have AP Academy, Wonder World, different opportunities we've had to evangelize, to be out there. So how should we do it? Pastors complain a lot about not having enough evangelism funds. Our conference is sort of strapped financially, and we haven't had evangelism funds for a number of years, but every time we get together, and one of the things that we complain about as pastors, like, man, I wish we were so broke we could have some evangelism funds, then we could really do some stuff. Well, today I want to tell you about a different way. One time I preached a sermon at a previous church. I called it Church on the Cheap. Evangelism that doesn't cost any money. Evangelism that is free is found, this quote I want to share with you in Ministry of Healing, page 143. Let's read this together. Christ's method alone will give true success in reaching the people. The Savior mingled with men as one who desired their good. How much does it cost to mingle? How much does it cost just to hang out with people? How much does it cost to just sort of rub shoulders with people in your neighborhood, at school? Jesus mingled. The Savior mingled with men as one who desired their good. He mingled. He showed his sympathy for them, caring, understanding, trying to get into their lives, see where they're at. He ministered to their needs, his healing that he did. Is feeding. He won their confidence. Very important part. He developed credibility. He won their confidence, their trust. So when he spoke the words of life, when he told a parable, when he had midnight talks with Nicodemus, when he did different things, he had credibility and they listened, and then he bade them follow me. Christ's method of evangelism. Called incarnation. As an incarnational ministry, big long word, but it means, you know, coming to be with people. Jesus came to be with us, to live with us, to care for us. He served us. Jesus invites us to join him in a serving and a caring capacity, and to invite others to join him. Incarnational ministry. So the question we have is, how is our backyard? What can we do to work on our backyard? 2019 challenge, discipleship. Driven is to intensify our personal relationship with Jesus. Just to let our love, our relationship with Jesus, just overflow naturally. To spill out, to bleed.